One thing that I've learned from being on Maui all these years is that the talent keeps rising and the moves just keep getting bigger.
The sailing now
was not possible
back in the day.
You couldn't have even imagined a real windsurfer on a real wave. Now you take a little toy windsurfer and go, imagine if you could do that and like fly in the air. And now we do it every day.
It's taken about 20 years, but the sailing now is deserving of that kind of attention again.
Now is a great time to be a windsurfer.
As windsurfing's first generation has grown up and had families, they've started to pass the sport on to their children. Answering the call, manufacturers have released a whole range of gear specifically designed for kids. As a result, for the first time ever, there is a worldwide youth movement in windsurfing. Leading the charge is a young Hawaiian waterman.
Thank you.
playtime, I usually just watch the trees. And right after school, my dad picks me up, go straight to Hachifa, down to the beach. Looking out at dirty old
middle name kind of gave it away and set things in motion for what was to come, I think. Waterman. Other than being a miniature version, he's one of the best riders out there in terms of looking at his wave knowledge and watching the dynamics of his riding.
From Silt, these past couple days have been no windsurfing, just sitting down. A little cold, but all the pros are out and we're having so much fun.
One thing's for certain, Kai Lenny's going to be one of the future figureheads of this sport if he chooses to continue to follow the windsurfing path.
With a young star like Robbie Nash before him, Kai is setting his sights high.
I want to compete on the World Cup. That's how Robbie made his mark on the sport, and that's the road I want to go down.
For me, the sport for a really long time was based around competition. It was my everything, my whole life, my whole approach to living was competition. You could never do anything if you're going to an event or from an event, that's all you would do. Because there's no way you could do anything with all this gear in between. It would all get stolen or lost, or if it was a three-discipline World Cup, 10 boards. 14 rigs and a mast, a boom, and a base for every one of those sails, because you have to have them all rigged all the time, ready to go. So for 25 years flying around, I never saw anything anywhere I went, because I just went straight into the event site and straight out. It's classic. Well, I've never actually counted how many trophies I've got or how many events I've won or placed in over the years. At least got a room for them now, for all the trophies that I've got somewhere to live, which is cool. That's a special one. That's actually the first real event I ever won. It's 1976 Regional Kailua Oahu, Hawaii. No, I'm proud of what I've done. I'm amazed that I've stayed as passionate about it as I have for as long as I have, but I'm as fired up about it today as I was 25 years ago. My life right now pretty much rocks because I still consider myself a professional athlete, which is cool at 44. I can sail what I want, where I want, how I want. Katie and I just had a baby girl, Christina Catherine Kaiulani Nash. You know, I replaced the competition side with the business side, and that's keeping me driven, you know, and having fun, not just on the water, but behind the scenes as well. It's a lot easier to travel now too, because I can get on a plane with one board bag and one sail bag and off I go. And there's not 300 kilos of gear following me around. So it's exciting times. It's like being a kid again.